unloved and overgrown. It's what remains of many red zone properties. But not these sections. Brian Fairburn, with the help of his wife Colleen, are a retired couple changing the look of abandoned Eastside land.
When I suddenly see the grass here about 12 to 18 inches long, sorry, there's no need for that. We didn't have to put up with that, so I decided I would do something about it.
Pruning, ploughing and mowing what remains of over 20 sections. That's 4 hectares of gardening, but Brian doesn't seem to mind.
We don't have to put up with the rubbish that we've had to put up with. We can do something about it, but I think we've got to get out and do it.
Using a bit of Kiwi ingenuity to keep it all alive.
The council's taken the water supply off, which is understandable because the cost to maintain it is ridiculous. So that leaves me with the only water I've got is bore water. I need to look after these bore pipes, make sure they didn't get knocked at all. So we flogged some water off some old fences and made up some garden boxes.
It's not his land though. It's owned by the Canterbury Earthquake Recovery Authority, which means he receives no funding.
It's coming out of the back pocket. We're getting a lot of donations, which is covering it now, which is good. But the Chancellor of my Exchequer forks out the money on a regular basis, so keeps her busy.
To date, he's spent $4,700, but the community are now backing his hobby. This classic car show was held over the weekend, raising $1,800. A gathering of classic car enthusiasts doing their bit to help one local man.
And Colleen said to me on the weekend, you just stop and listen, and you hear the kids are playing, and the laughter and the peals of laughter from the kids. That's brilliant, absolutely brilliant.
Like many, the Fairburns lost their property in the 2011 quakes. Filling the desolate Eastside area is giving hope back to their community.
A lot of the locals stop, and what they like is the fact that something is coming back. Instead of looking at the demolition and the empty sections like across the road with the house just gone, they're now seeing something coming back.
But how long can he keep this up? Sarah have told him it's a temporary project, but no plans are set in stone for what the land could be used for instead.
Come a time when it'll simply become too big, but I'll stop before it gets to that, because it's got to be carried on. You can't just do it and stop. That's just being a wee bit silly. So no, I don't see anything to it at this stage.
Brian's gardening oasis is forever expanding. This house soon to become just another part of Canterbury's Red Zone Park. Emma Cropper, CTV News.